Coming to play in Atlanta. How was that process?
Last week I was basically told that I was going to be traded, and it was just a matter of figuring out where and when I was going to go. So finally I was told that it was going to be Atlanta, and it was just nice to know where I was going to be so I could start focusing my mind on, you know, where I was going, where I was going to be living, what team I could hopefully be contributing to. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of just how it came about.
And what was your first practice like with the beat?
The first practice was really good. I felt like the training environment was awesome. And, I was coming in on basically 2 or 3 hours of sleep, which made it a little bit more difficult just because I had to relocate. But the training setup was great, the girls were great, and really welcoming to me, which I think was really important so that I could step on the field in the weekend and, you know, perform to the best of my ability.
You just had your first game with the beat. Can you give us some overall thoughts about how you thought that went?
You know, obviously I'm a competitor, and, you know, I wanted to win, and I wanted to come and, you know, in my debut help the team get 3 points, you know, at least a point. So I was a little disappointed in that, but I was not at all disappointed in the environment, in the way we played. I thought it was really entertaining. It had some really good moments. And so for me, it was such a blessing just to get in the first game and to have it be a good team effort overall.
In your first game, you scored a goal for us. How did that feel? What was that like?
It felt really good. I haven't gotten many minutes this season, and so to get a 90-minute game was great and was something that I was looking forward to. And then to get a goal on top of it was just the icing on the cake, get my first goal of the season, and hopefully now there will be more to come.
Now, can you tell me about the sprinklers at the end of the game? What happened with that?
Well, I was over signing autographs for a little bit, and the sprinklers just came on, like, right in my face, and I realized I had to go do an interview as well. So I remember coming to you and to the newspaper and getting the interview, and we tried to move out of the way and tried to go by the stands where we figured it would be safe, and all of a sudden the sprinklers start following us and start coming on us. But it felt good for me. I felt a little bit bad for you guys, but luckily you stood there and took it and got the interview done.
Yes. What are you most looking forward to for the second half of your season being with the Beat?
I think I'm looking forward to really contributing to the team concept here. I think that this organization has a great thing going, and I got really excited just being a part of it in the game, seeing it come to fruition. And I'm looking forward to, you know, hopefully continuing a winning mentality and a competitive mentality that I know is here. And I know that the Beat's looking for more points and looking to rise in the standings, and I just hope I can be a positive part of that.
Now, I heard that you can count to 10 in 10 different languages.
Oh, no.
Can we please hear it?
You're putting me on the spot. I have, like, a little confession to make. I have a few, but I researched a little bit to make it 10, so it would be even more impressions. So you caught me. I don't know actually 10.
How many do you know?
On the spot right now? Maybe 4 or 5, something like that.
Let's see what you got.
Okay, well, English, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All
Spanish.
Right. 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, 2.
Swedish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right.
German, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay.
Is that 4?
That's 4.
Oh, my goodness.
We're getting there.
I knew sign language, and this is gonna, I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it, though. You totally caught me. Now I'm embarrassed. I'm just kidding. But I got 4. I'm excited about the 4.
That's
but I did enough. Have Swahili, Portuguese, sign language, Japanese, and one other really weird one. But I had to come up with it, because I don't have a whole ton of talent, so this is what I came up with.
Well, keep working on it, and we'll come back to it.
Okay, I'll follow up.
Can you tell the Beat fans why you think Atlanta is awesome?
The city or the team?
Both.
Okay. The easiest thing to start with is the team. I was really excited to come here because I had a ton of good friends on the team, and I felt like this could be an environment that I would not only thrive in for my career, but that I would enjoy the people I was around. And it's just held true with even the people that I've met within the organization, the other girls on the team that I didn't know, and just the way things were ran. I was just really happy to be a part of that, and I think it's a great setup and a great environment. As far as the area, I don't know it that well, but you know, I just am excited to get to know the city and to get to know the fans. There was great support. And so from what I can tell, the city of Atlanta has great people and that are willing to come out and support the beat, which I love.
The one in the mirror ain't me. It's just someone that I call B.O.B. It's kind of me, but it's not. It's just a mask that I got so that I can rap and get off my block. Reminiscing my past when I was a toddler sitting in